I need someone to show me my place in all this.
Nothing will stand in our way.
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
I will finish what you started.
Who are you?
I'm no one. There are stories about what happened.
It's true. All of it.
The Force. It's calling to you.
May the Force be with us.
My word, world.
Just let it in.
Good job, Bob.
Why does she get a blaster and I do?
Good job, Bob.
It's going to take me a good bit of time to digest the 2.5 hours that I just spent in the movie theater watching Star Wars Episode 8, The Last Jedi. I'll just say up front, I loved it. I'm not going to give any spoilers away on the show this week. I probably shouldn't even number this particular show, because my intention is I'll do a full spoiler review in the coming days. It's pretty late on Thursday. I got to go to work tomorrow. I'm seeing the movie again tomorrow morning when I get off the air, and I understand now why so many of the people who've seen it once or twice, and most of the people who've seen it twice, have said, you know, you got to go a second time, because this movie takes some digesting. It is such a ride. It is so filled with action, with emotion, with passion, with excitement, with mythology, with strangeness, that it's just, I don't know the last time I went on a ride like that. And it was easily the singular most enriching Star Wars experience that I've had in the theater. None of the prequels gripped me the way that this movie gripped me. The Force Awakens didn't grip me the way that this movie gripped me. You know, I had to go back to the original trilogy, but then I was a kid. I mean, I was such a young kid, and I'm listening to my 11-year-old, and I'm imagining my 11-year-old self after seeing the movie, and we're all discussing it in the car on the drive home, and he's keying in on different things, and I'm getting all these thoughts of the mythology and what took place, and I just want to say I loved it. I need to see it again to really unpack it and to break it down. It could possibly be my favorite Star Wars movie ever. That's really tough to say, because all of them I love so much. I do like it more than The Force Awakens, and so I guess at the moment it's sitting at the top of my list. But you can't get to... It's really fascinating, because you can't get to The Last Jedi without going through The Force Awakens. And for everybody who complained about The Force Awakens being like a rehash of the other movies, I'm sorry, you can't get to something like The Last Jedi, which takes a ton of risks and is incredibly unique. I mean, for everybody that was complaining, The Force Awakens was a rehash of A New Hope or the complete original trilogy. Well, you've got something completely different in Rian Johnson and what he brought to this movie. And it does open up the world. I'm going to keep it so vague, because listening to other reviews, non-spoiler reviews, even I at this point wish that I hadn't listened to those non-spoiler ones, because this was the most in the dark that I've gone into watching a film, apart from when I was a kid, okay? And maybe The Phantom Menace. I didn't know a lot about what was going to happen in The Phantom Menace, but I knew most of what was going to happen in Attack of the Clones, knew most of what was going to happen in Revenge of the Sith, and that's an easy one, too, because we kind of know where that story's going. You're not going to get a bunch of revelations in Revenge of the Sith if you've been, if you're a fan of Star Wars. And, you know, Rogue One, I didn't know kind of plot, you know, where the plot was going to hit the beats. But you knew that, you know, eventually, more than likely, spoiler alert, everybody had to die and they were going to get the Death Star plans. And so I really did, I read a lot of leaks of people who said they saw it. And they did. They didn't. It's obvious. Nobody. I've spent the past 2 years on the Reddit leaks page and didn't hear anybody get it right of what this movie tells and the theories that were out there. There was one thing that I thought was going to happen in the movie that I told my wife about that did happen in the movie. Not exactly the way I thought it was going to play out, but there was a very specific scene that I thought was going to play out in the film, and I was right. And it wasn't a very hard thing to deduce. I just kind of figured it was going to happen. And I'll explain that when I do the longer spoiler review going into, into probably Sunday or Monday, I'll do that. I want to make sure that people have time to go and watch this movie first before I put out a spoiler review. But what I was trying to say was I almost wish I had gone in completely in the dark, apart from what I'd seen on the trailers and not heard other people's opinions. Not that it had any effect on my viewing. There were a few moments where I was sort of looking at it through the lens of what other people had said, and I wish I hadn't done that, because it really is a special movie, and it has so many special moments, and it really does up the game of Star Wars. It has opened up the world, and I don't know if it was Rian Johnson's intention, but he has now laid out, in my opinion, a foundation moving forward that goes beyond 9. In my view. And it's one of these films where I kind of walked out just stunned. And I did the same thing when I saw The Force Awakens. I just kind of walked out of The Force Awakens not really sure of my footing, like knowing that I really, really liked what I saw, but it's a different vibe. It's just a different vibe. Like, you know, you walk out of something like Thor Ragnarok, and I really liked that movie, and it was a lot of fun, and I laughed really hard, and like, wow, that was a really fun ride. That was great. You know, you walk out of a movie like The Force Awakens, and man, you went on a journey, and it kind of beat you up along the way. And I just sat wide-eyed and just mouth open, just watching this. And I can say that it hands down has some of my favorite moments ever from any Star Wars movies. I will say that right up front. That there are things in this movie that immediately went, yep, that's one of my favorite moments of Star Wars altogether. And I don't know if I can say that about The Force Awakens. I can probably say it about the lightsaber duel between Rey and Kylo at the end. I'm smiling, and I don't want to tell you why I'm smiling, but I can kind of say that about the lightsaber duel at the end of The Force Awakens, but not as many nearly in The Force Awakens than what I have in here. The sequences, the action in this film is insane. So good. And the mythology is amazing as well. And when people say it's weird, yeah, it's weird. It is weird. There's no doubt about that. But the original trilogy was weird. There were weird moments that we didn't understand that I still constantly go and read about the Force Cave in The Empire Strikes Back and, you know, the weirdness of it. And there was weirdness in the prequel trilogy. The ability of Anakin to go and see the visions that he was seeing of Padme dying. I mean, there was weirdness in those movies as well. And this is not, you know, all that different. And sometimes I forget that. And watching the film, I go, this is strange. And I go, well, Star Wars is kind of strange. I mean, it's a galaxy far, far away. And what I liked about it was that, of the many things that I liked about it, but when we're talking about the weirdness, what I liked about the weirdness was the fact that, you know, Rian Johnson made the weirdness different. It was weirdness that we hadn't seen before, but it was all very much still in the Star Wars universe. And I couldn't have asked for anything more. It absolutely did not disappoint at all. I can't wait to go and see it again tomorrow. Now that I've had a chance to watch it once, to sit down and now take a and breathe, just breathe, and then just take it all in and watch it play out, knowing where it's going. It's just a different experience. And I know that many people who have seen the movie twice now have said the same thing, that upon a second viewing, it really goes up a notch. But if you haven't seen it yet, you're in for something special. Keep an incredibly open mind. I will say that. You know, we love Star Wars, and this is a very different, unique vision of that thing that we love so much, and that's what's special now about Star Wars. It was special when George Lucas was crafting it because this was his vision. And what I think is special about it now is we have these amazing directors who are fans of what George Lucas was doing and are now putting their own stamp and vision on it and making it their own. And not so much saying their interpretation, but playing in their own Star Wars universe and giving us something new and special. And Rogue One does that. I mean, I love that movie, but the more I watch it, the more I enjoy it, and the more I kind of see, man, this is, you know, Gareth Edwards and Tony Gilroy's version and vision of Star Wars and what they gave to us. And this certainly is Rian Johnson's vision, and what a vision and what a spectacle it is, man. I can't wait to get into the spoiler part of it. And there was a friend of mine through Facebook who was with me through Facebook when The Force Awakens came out. I remember very specifically, and we haven't talked very often, but we were talking about maybe having them come on the show and join me, and I may just have to do that. I think I'm going to have to get a few people on to discuss and break down The Last Jedi when I work on a spoiler review. But I need to go get some sleep, and I just got a big smile on my face, man. The more I think about this movie and the whole ride home, the more I was just kind of filled with this joy that, you know, was on this journey for 2 years from The Force Awakens and wanting to see where it was going to go and having all these questions. And I left that movie theater with more questions, but completely satisfied and so excited to now be able to live with this new movie and to be able to go back and watch The Force Awakens in the wake of it. Oh, I can't wait to watch The Force Awakens now, knowing what happens. I mean, that's just going to be a whole new experience. So if you haven't seen it yet, you're in for a real treat, and I want to hear from you. So feel free in this particular show, if you're on YouTube for this show, please don't drop any spoilers in the comments for anybody that hasn't seen it yet. I hate the fact there's been people out there that have been spoiling this movie, and thankfully I wasn't spoiled, and I'm so grateful that I wasn't. But, you know, this needs to be a journey of discovery for all the fans out there who have kept themselves in the dark to go and just watch this amazing motion picture play out on the big screen. So you can find it on YouTube. Don't put any spoilers in there. I'll have another show up in the next couple of days when I have a chance to digest it a little more, watch it two more times this weekend, and then I'll break down and do a spoiler review. You can find the podcast on a Podbean, Stitcher, Spreaker, iTunes, and of course on YouTube as well. Drop me an email, talkshownerd@gmail.com. And have yourself a great Star Wars weekend. I can't wait to hear from you and what you guys think. Yeah, boy, I'm going to sleep great tonight. And I got a big old smile on my face, man. Thank you, Rian Johnson. And Rian Johnson, I trust, and I can't wait for that trilogy he's going to create. And I can't wait to see what J.J. Abrams does with what Rian Johnson has created. So may the Force be with you always.